Around the time of Sudan's birth, teams of animal catchers were coming to Africa. They were in search of exotic creatures to stock the new safari parks, opening up all over America and Europe. In 1974, a team from England headed to South Sudan, hoping to find some northern white rhinos.
We had to find the right size. Something that's definitely weaned, but not too grown either, so that they were pretty easy to shape, you could say. They would tame down and adjust easier to a different life. We kept a very strict rule never to chase an animal more than 2 minutes. If you chase them too much, they stand to get a heart failure. We had a rope with a noose at the end to put around the neck of the animals, and the other end of the rope was fastened in your vehicle. So then you could slow down so that you didn't strangle the animal, but made it stop. The whole process needed to be done very fast. So you sort of surprised them. Sudan was 2 years old. He was the youngest of the whole lot that we caught.
Sudan was destined for a new and very different life in captivity.
You have to remember in those days there was so much wildlife around. Herds of 1,000 and more elephants was not uncommon at all. I don't think anybody sees that many elephants in one herd today. So it was like, sure, you take a few individuals to go to safari parks so people in Europe can see these animals and appreciate them.
Today, in old Pajeta, Sudan has reached the grand old age of 43.
Come on, boy.
Older than most rhinos live to be.
Little boy, Sudan.